Hello and welcome to Pursuit a Perfect System. My name is Terry Ellis, I'm an audio reviewer, and this is my video coverage for the Munich High-End Show 2019. I'd like to thank my show coverage sponsors. Melco, GIK Acoustics, Tellurium Q. I have created lots of videos as part of a coverage for the high-end show, and you'll find other videos like this in my channel. I hope you enjoy this video. If you do, hit that like button, make sure you've subscribed to the channel, and I'll be seeing you all soon.
What we'd like to do now is show you what can be achieved from the latest immersive format. What I better do is introduce the system for you to give you an idea of what you're actually listening to. What we've done is we've mimicked as close as we can to the system that we've got installed at Capitol Studios in LA. The only biggest difference is instead of using our professional active monitors, we're using our flagship consumer monitor, which is still a three-way design, but this is the Fat Finestria LCR. And you'll notice that they're in the same metallic graphite as you saw the FACT signature models. So that's just a new element that's been introduced to the FACT Finestria. So LCR, FACT Finestria, and then we've got 10 channels of surround of the wafer 2, and then we've got 6 height channels of wafer 2 on the gantries above here. For the LFE sub-channels, we're running 2 QB1 subs, which are actually behind this wall just here. On this curved wall here. Processing is the Bryston SP4 processor, and all the channels are driven by Bryston power amplification. What I'd like to do is introduce you now to Maurice Batiste. Maurice is head of PMC USA, and has got notoriety amongst the studio and professional users out there in the over the pond there. He's far more accomplished than myself to introduce the luminaries that we've got here today for you. And also, he knows a lot more about the technologies and the techniques that have been involved with it. So if I hand over to Maurice.
I got the easy part. Can you hear me well?
Yeah.
Yeah. Because otherwise we use microphones and all. And I'm an engineer. We don't like microphones. So stay away from it. Before anything else, we're the consumer show. It's a hi-fi show, right? So what we do in the studios, especially what we're about to present, is usually off a computer in converters, and we can play it back. Now, obviously, not everybody has that luxury at home, but what we do have is CD players. Some people have reel-to-reels, or you might even have a Blu-ray. The beauty of Blu-ray is that it's an amazing format that can hold both video and audio at high resolution. And Stefan Bach of Pure Audio, Stefan, where are you? He's not here. He was here, and he will be here. He was gracious enough to help us out to basically turn our mixes that we made onto a Blu-ray so that we actually can play back for you. So it's not just a studio product, what we are about to present you. It actually exists already. Stefan has made quite a few of it. But it's basically Dolby Atmos music on a Blu-ray. And up till now, for Dolby Atmos, you were only able to do it at 2448. We ended up doing it a little bit higher, in 2496 at Capitol. We knew that it was possible, so we made some changes. So what we are about to present you is actually in 2496, but because we go down to the consumer, we had to bring it back to 2448, because there is no consumer processor yet that can do that 96. But we have it. We actually have the first official 2496 Dolby Atmos recording, which is the Miles Davis kind of blue that we made. But before I go there, I am thrilled that we have been able to get a real group of people together that has made some amazing content that we want to share with you, specifically for this show. Everybody will ask me afterwards, where can I buy it? You can't. It doesn't exist yet, in the sense that you cannot buy it yet, but I think if everybody keeps asking for it, it will absolutely be there. And for that purpose, we were extremely delighted that we had Jim Anderson and Ulrike Anderson that have been working on many, many projects. I'm not even going to list out all the people that they've worked with and all their accomplishments, because I'll be here tomorrow. You don't have that time. To start it, I just want to play you a piece of music, and it's only going to be like 2 minutes because we don't have time to get through the whole track. We kind of want to give you a taste of what you actually can do when you start using Dolby Atmos, which is known as a movie format, actually purely for music. And after that, we'll go through a few more tracks to give you a sense of it, but hopefully whet the appetite a little bit to join us later in the full presentations, because then we have a lot more time. So if we're able to get that up, almost there. Like I said, the beauty is with pure audio that actually off your remote, you can literally just click a track number and a color code if you, for instance, want to switch between stereo and Atmos and perhaps 5.1. Stefan was kind enough to make us a Blu-ray for this. Like I said, it's the only one that exists, and it's mine. Can't get it. Let's play some music. That's what we're here for. You hear this? That's good. Also, by the way, the room that it was all mixed in is that room. That's Capitol C. That's a studio that we basically redesigned about 20 months ago, Steve? About 20 months ago, yeah. Because they are on the forefront of this type of technology at Capitol, and for us as PMC, we have been partnered with Capitol for the last 6 years, and extremely exciting to be able to do all of this. And that brings us actually to the next part and part of the event actually that I want to share with you. A couple of years ago, myself and Dave Rideau. Dave, where are you? Oh, there he is, the dude in the back, the tall one. We were involved in a remix of Sketches of Spain, Miles Davis, in 5.1. And it was really exciting. We did a presentation for that, and it's quite amazing to hear that type of music. And fast forward a couple of years, Steve actually was mixing an Arturo Sandoval track, another minor trumpet player, who was singing, who was joined by Placido, and an amazing track. I was just completely blown away. We will also play that for you later. But that kind of gave me the light bulb moment, like, oh, wait, trumpet, Atmos? Oh, I think I might know somebody. So we did a Grammy event, and we invited Vince Wilburn and Aaron Davis from the Miles Davis estate, which are respectively his nephew and his son, that run, basically, that manage the Miles Davis estate. And I invited them over and said, listen to this. What do you think? And they were like, wow, okay, that's amazing. I was like, what about Miles? And they were like, okay. I said, what about Kind of Blue? Thinking like, that's never going to happen. Sony has the tapes and everything. And sure enough, here we are. We will be able to play it for you because we got the masters. We were able to turn it into a remix Dolby Atmos version. And I know people will have a lot of questions about Dolby Atmos, the format, the technology, and how it should be utilized, because it's the same with 5.1. In the beginning, it was all ping pong all over the place. It really is part of the creative process, what the engineer decides to do with it, or the artist. But if you have any questions whatsoever later about the Dolby Atmos format, the technical questions, we have David Ziegler here from Dolby. Look at this pin. It says Dolby. That's the guy. He will be more than happy to answer any questions that you have. What we will do now is I will play you a track and start wondering what the hell did I get myself into. And then we will also show you a little bit how this came together and how we made it. We made a little video of that, so I hope you enjoy it. When we got the masters, it's a tree track. It's a tree track master. And we were like, okay, let's take this, because we had the original vinyl mono, 1959. We had the 61 stereo, which is this one, also. So we made all the original transfers. We took the 1997 version, the Sony Legacy, or the Legacy recordings. So we had references. And then we got the masters, and we started playing them, and we're like, how the hell did they screw that up? The masters are so good, phenomenally recorded. It's like incredible. And we were like, done. It almost went like that. Now, we would like to play you a little bit of a video, because people are like, well, if it was a tree track, what the hell did you do? You know, this is a 1959 recording. It's actually the 60th anniversary of the recording of Kind of Blue. So it's kind of appropriate that we do this, I think. And thankfully, we have the blessing and the appearance here of both Aaron and Vince Wilburn and the family and the people that run the estate, to make sure that we don't get the Miles Davis police after us. But yeah, if you see this, then you hopefully get an idea what I had in mind and where myself and Dave and the family decided to take it. So it gives you a bit of an idea.
Video's in stereo.
It's in stereo, not
Atmos. Yeah, no idea.
This is all about giving people a musical experience. I think we need to go old school.
Yeah, exactly.
You know what I mean? Exactly. Like, this is 1957,
yeah.
Or, you know, and yeah. I feel that that is, we kind of need to take that approach.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, of course, we can use the technology to help us,
yeah.
But it shouldn't take over.
Yeah, we're listening to probably as you would the original masters.
Yeah. So we're just going to literally open that whole thing up, but gradually bringing you into that room.
Yeah.
And that's the beauty, I think, of Atmos, where, you know, you take it out of Capitol and you go to a stage somewhere that is 16 times the size. So it's just something that is grand, and how much grander can we make it? Stay natural. And... you know, I want to have that dynamic range. So Steve, what are we doing?
So we're going to take our three-track album and reamp it into this room. And we've set up an array of microphones that kind of mimic where our speakers are.
So as you can see, the speakers are set up, literally bouncing off the glass. And then we'll use the space. Add some air to it. Really pick up that top. Let's see what it sounds like in a control room when we start playing something back. Has influenced, well, me definitely, but so many others before me and hopefully after me. Basically mixing in Dolby Atmos instead of stereo or just 5-1,
No, we basically make this room one big sound field.
Right.
It was as if I was in the orchestra.
I got lost in there. I felt lost. I was just inside the music. For me, it's a little bit, for me and Vince, it's very emotional. Just anytime I put on my own, but I just got completely immersive in that. It's just immersed. You're there with them, and you're kind of understanding now how this record was made from the room that they were in.
You just opened it up to the people, where you can hear every nuance. You can kind of get a feel for it, and kind of blew the way Jimmy kind of rode this ride. The 11s are blue and green. It's a touch. It's a transformation. Miles would have loved this. Uncle would have loved this.
My favorite track from Sketches of Spain is Soleil, and it just, I don't really want to hear it any other way now. I don't want to hear it with headphones. I don't want to hear it in my car. I want to hear it like this.
If you love music, this is what it is. There's no other way.
So yeah, somebody tells me I have a job. That was not a job. That was fun. I hope it gives you a little bit of an idea. There might be tons of other questions, but one thing I definitely want to pass on to you is that, like I said, the masters were so good, it was so well recorded, that, like I said early on, we decided to go old school. That means we got to have a chamber. So we didn't use any digital reverbs. We didn't use any EQ. We didn't use any compressor.
What kind of master did you use? The tape?
So what you hear is tape. Yeah, the masters were tape converted into 24/192s. So we worked in high res. And then now obviously we had to bring it down in 48 to be able to play it back for you. But that's just a little bit of the background on that. But like I said, we have been extremely fortunate to work in Capitol Studios and with Capitol Studios for so many years now. And I've spent quite a bit of time with Steve in the studio, especially on the Atmos side, because at the end of the day, it's all about the music, right? We want to make music that everybody can listen to. That's what this is about. And, Dave, has been working forever, also in Capitol with us, but in his own studio. I mean, I I'm not even going to start talking about who he worked with. The same goes for Steve. People will know him for all of his work that he also did with Al Smith, for instance. But I want to go back to what started it for me, going down the Miles Davis route. And that was actually a track that Steve recorded, Arturo Sandoval and Placido Domingo. I'd like to play that so you get a sense of what he did with that. So it wasn't a tree track, they had a little bit more.
Melancolia, e di rotere,
I can imagine what I thought when I heard it the first time. It's like, whoa, wait a moment. I think, like we said earlier, it is all about the music. And music is subjective, it's personal. It's our task in the studios to make content that hopefully you can enjoy at home. For us being so close to the people in the studio that allow us to work with them even to this extent, and then bringing it back into people's homes and utilizing technology as a tool, hopefully the proper way. But I think Dolby Atmos has absolutely something that is exciting, that I think will open music up to a lot more people again.
I just want to say that we were proud owners of PMC speakers long before this project.
I had to say it. Aaron and I both have recording studios in Los Angeles. So.
Thank you. I think that's concluded for us. So if you can, thank you very much.
Thanks for coming.
Thank you.